Aquaproof 7-in-1. High-performing waterproofing paint, Nippon Paint. The coatings expert.
The entire world seems toothless when it comes to Israel. Now, the founding ideology of the ethno-national Jewish state contained a few Palestinians. They would have ideally wanted no Palestinians to exist within the Israeli territory. But the fact remains, there is Gaza Strip now, there is the West Bank, and there is East Jerusalem. There is also quite a number, almost 30% of Arabs living within the state of Israel, apart from the West Bank, Gaza Strip, and the Golan Heights. Therefore, Mr. Speaker, it is now time for us to call this to a halt. In this regard, it is important for us to realize that this whole attempt by the Prime Minister Netanyahu to say there was the original pledge given that he will free the hostages. None of us want the hostages to be harmed. We all the peace-loving people in the world want all these hostages to be released, and we make that appeal to Hamas to see that they are released unarmed, unharmed. But unfortunately, there may be few who would have already met with their deaths. And then, recently, the Egyptian negotiators, along with the Qatari negotiators, came to negotiate, and Hamas, the Israeli demand to release all the hostages, both civilian and military hostages, was placed before them. Israelis didn't expect Hamas to accept that condition. But having accepted the condition, now they have gone back on it. What does it show? Therefore, it has never been the intention of the current Israeli administration to free the hostages. They want to finally sacrifice the hostages, but eliminate the entire civilian population from the Gaza Strip. And this is an unfolding genocide. And this has to be called into question. Therefore, we see the hostages is simply a sideshow. So, now that even by yesterday, the Egyptian government has publicly announced that they will support the South African demand to haul up the Palestinians or the Israeli government, the case before the ICJ, the Egyptians also will start supporting. It's unfortunate that many countries in the region still maintain diplomatic relations despite the fact that such atrocities are taking place. Therefore, in the humanity's name, we are requesting that even we take a bold stand. What is happening today? Even our government, His Excellency the President, I am the Honorable State Minister for Foreign Affairs, is here. I heard him the other day. He was here on the 2 days ago in a parliamentary debate. He is bragging about the achievement of the President. What is the achievement? He says, we have balanced Israelis and Iranians. We got the Iranian president to come here, and we also sent our naval force to Red Sea. What a shame, Mr. Foreign Minister. You claim that this is one of the biggest achievements in foreign policy. What a shame, right? You all are waiting with monies collected by poor civilians all over the country for the people in Gaza. You collect that money from various mosques and schools and various others. Have collected the monies and you are posing a photograph, right? There are some shameless parliamentarians also going and posing with them. And some of our parliamentarians also seen posing, giving this money. But what is your president doing? He is rocking the cradle and pinching the baby. That is what he is doing. By going and supporting the American request. You know, we have become virtual slaves to the US. This bear hug diplomacy by the by President Biden, right? Bear hug diplomacy, they call it, right? That is the main cause. They are giving them bombs. They are giving the 2,000 pound bombs to bomb the entire Gaza Strip, right? Whereas the entire Democratic Party, majority of them, vast majority of them, are against the military assistance being given to this genocidal Israeli administration. Mr. State Minister, you can reply. You will have your time, right? But what I'm saying is, I'm calling into question your justification and your bragging about this whole concept. Mr. Speaker, I have very limited time. Now, I am also taking the time that is allocated to Honorable Ali Zahir Maulana. You add that on to my time as well, Mr. Speaker. So I know the Honorable State Minister is very, very restless, right? When we try to point out his slavish attitude towards this imperialist U.S. administration and the Israelis, what about your labor minister? He is sending his people. The poor Sri Lankan workers are being sent to Israel to do what? To work in the Israeli farms to fill the vacancies created by the poor Gaza civilians, right? You chase the Gaza people out, you deprive their livelihood, you kill them in thousands and thousands, you kill children, women, old people, right? And then go. And since the vacancies have been created in those farms, right, you send our poor Sri Lankan workers there. Because of the economic plight your government has pushed this country into, there is no other means. There are people who are willing to go. They are also etanudu thallasganno. හරි මෙතුමා කියනවා මේක විශාල රාජතාන්ත්‍රික මේ ජයග්‍රහණයක්ලු මොකද මේ අපේ ඉරානයේ ජනාධිපතිතුමා ආපු එක ඉරානයේ ජනාධිපතිතුමාට ඔබතුමාගේ අමාත්‍යතුමා තමයි ගිහිල්ලා මේ ඇරයුමක් දුන්නේ එන්න කියලා මේ මේ මේක අපි මහින්ද රාජපක්ෂ මැතිතුමාගේ කාලේ මේ උමාඔය ව්‍යාපෘතිය පටන් ගත්තේ එතුමාට තිබුණා ලොකු සැලකිල්ලක් ඒ කාලේ ඉරානයේ රාජ්‍යයේ ඒ හින්දා ලැබුණු ඒ පරිත්‍යාගය ඒක උඩ ඕගොල්ලෝ නම් දාගන්න හදනවා මේ බොරු ෂෝ එක පෙන්වන්න එපා අමාත්‍යතුමා මේ බොරු ෂෝ එක ගිහිල්ලා මේ ලෙව කනවා ඊශ්‍රායලයන්ගේ වොමනාවට මූන්ගේ සල්ලි
රැට මේ
ජනාධිපතිතුමා ඔව් දවල්
දුලිජාගේ
ඔව් දවල් රෑ ඩැනියල් දවල් මිගෙල් ඒක තමයි දැන් සමහරු කරන්නේ අපේ පැත්තනුත්. ඉතින් ඒකෙනත් අපි සැලකිලිමත් වෙනවා. නමුත් ඉතින් අපේ රාජ්‍ය අමාත්‍යතුමා කොච්චර දැඟලුවත් තේරුමක් නැහැ. මේක දැන් මහ ජනතාව පිළියම් ඉවරයි ජනා මේ කතානායකතුමනි. දැන් තත්ත්වයේ පිළිබඳව හොඳ පැහැදීමක් තියෙනවා.
Let him make a small reply and
hurry.
Right, you go ahead.
අනායකතුමනි මම මගේ වෙලාවෙන් ඉල්ලුවේ මම කිව්වේ මෙතුමා
මගේ නම කිව්වා
so I think I regret the attitude of the honorable member first of all and I think he also is misrepresenting what I stated that we took part in the combined marine forces because it's in our interest I think you know just because the honorable member wants to cut all ties with Israel we as a country will also look in at Sri Lanka's interest and that does not mean that we will abandon the people of Palestine and I think the honorable member is extremely jealous of with the attitude of the foreign policy which we have taken and the good links which we have all countries with the president so I'm very sorry that the honorable member feels this way